that. Haley says a false start. Yeah.
False alarm?
Yep. So I had to do a call to Clinton to come off of it.
Get in the room here. Kelly. I need a room.
I'm not.
Oh, yeah.
We thought of some more questions.
Stay back. Don't hit my handle. Cool.
Hi, Mr. President.
Mr. President,
with the Kavanaugh nomination.
And so we're heading out to Iowa where we have a big statement to make, as you know, on ethanol and for our farmers. Likewise, we're taking care of our refineries and our refiners, and they've done a fantastic job. But we want to get more fuel into the system, and it's a great thing. But they're great for our farmers, and it was a promise that I made during the campaign. And as you know, I keep my promises, so that's the way it is. So we're heading out to Iowa. Assume some of you are coming. Yes, please.
Mr. President, in terms of who may succeed Nikki Haley at the United Nations, the name Dina Powell is out there. That would be a trade, one strong woman for another. What are the chances of that happening?
Dina is certainly a person I would consider, and she is under consideration. We have actually many names. You know, Nikki has been great. Nikki's going to be working along with us and helping us with the choice, plus she's going to help us with 2020, and Nikki's a great friend of mine. We've become real friends over the last 3 months. She's done a fantastic job, and so she'll be involved, and Dina certainly, and there are others. I've heard a lot of names.
Would you consider
the people that know, there's nothing to do with nepotism. But I want to tell you, the people that know that Ivanka would be dynamite.
Would she take the job, sir?
But, you know, I'd then be accused of nepotism, if you can believe it, right? Yes.
Is it a serious consideration, though? Would she be a good fit for that job?
I think Ivanka would be incredible, but doesn't mean I'd give, you know, I'd pick her because you'd be accused of nepotism. Even though I'm not sure there's anybody more confident in the world, but that's okay. But we are looking at numerous people. And it is interesting.
Would you like to comment for Ambassador Haley's resignation? There's a lot of speculation about the timing on a day when you could be celebrating the Kavanaugh nomination.
We do a lot. You know, this administration does a lot. So you're right. Another administration would, after like the Kavanaugh victory, it's really a victory for the people. It's not for me. It's a victory to have a great justice for hopefully many years. But a lot of people would celebrate. We go back to business the next day. And, you know, Nikki and I talked about this a year ago, and she really wanted to be here for about 2 years. We finished our big week last week at the UN. We had a tremendous success. It was great. And we finished 30 days out, but, you know, Nikki's going to be involved with us for a long time. And she's going to help me also make that final pick. We're going to make a final pick. I want to get somebody really good. I think she's also brought a new level of prestige for that position. That position is, in terms of people wanting it, easier now in a way than it was before. But Nikki has brought, obviously, great confidence, but she's brought great prestige for that position.
On ethanol.
How do you keep your base energized? How do you have this Kavanaugh victory?
That's a very good question. How do you keep your base energized now that you have the big Kavanaugh victory? I would say that just by winning. Gotta keep winning. We're doing a lot of winning. We're very happy with the USMCA, which is the, I don't want to use the word NAFTA because it's a terrible word. This was a horrible deal for this country. But our deal with Mexico and Canada was fantastic. China wants to make a deal so badly. We'll see where it goes, but I don't think they're ready yet for it.
Mr. President,
on the other hand, will be energized because they saw the defeat of someone that they wanted.
Probably, I mean, there could be, but, you know, a lot of those were paid protesters. You saw that. They're all unhappy because they haven't been paid yet. I've been calling it. they were paid protesters. That was professional. That was orchestrated. When you look in the halls of Congress and you see screaming like that, and it's like chimes. One goes, the next goes. These are paid protesters. I don't know that their energy is great. I can tell you the energy on the Republican side, I don't think it's ever been greater. Maybe 2016, where, as you remember, the energy was very good. My man,
Mr. President.
Tell it to your father.
I will.
All right.
You've already got two Supreme Court justices through in your first term. How many more do you think you might get this term?
A lot of theories on that. It could be three. Under one theory, it could be four. And then some people could say two could happen. So, you know, it could anywhere be from, I would say, one or two to four additional. So we'll see.
Mr. President,
I hope everyone remains healthy. I'm very happy the way it is right now. And we put a great man, and I think going to be a great justice on the board. But, you know, it's a guessing game, you don't know. What is an honor is that there have been presidents, many presidents, that never had a choice. And here I am, not even 2 years, and we have two, and they're confirmed. And
You're meeting with Kanye West on Thursday, Mr. President.
Yeah, Kanye West is coming to the White House. He's been a terrific guy. You know, he loves what we're doing for African-American jobs, for so many different things. Median income, as you see, at an all-time high. Poverty level at the best rate, meaning the lowest rate so far. And Kanye is a smart guy, and he sees that. And also coming with him, he said, you mind if I bring Jim Brown, big Jim Brown? Boy, would he be making a lot of money today, right? He was, I call him unstoppable Jim Brown. And he's been a friend of mine. He's been really with us because he gets it. He really gets it. He sees that African-American, and by the way, Hispanic and Asian, have never done better in this country. And he likes it, my man.
What did you think about Kanye's comments
about you? Concerned about the way that China treated Secretary Pompeo when he was there on the phone?
No, they're just trying to get me a message, but those messages don't work. They don't work. But no, I think they treated him with great respect, actually. You know, they had meetings besides just the news conference, and I think they treated him with great respect. He had a great meeting with North Korea. And China, it wasn't so much, I guess he was giving them a message, and they were giving him a message to come back to me.
Do you have any updates about the Saudi journalist? Have you heard
anything? I don't know anything. No, I don't have any updates, no. It's a sad situation, yes.
Have you read the UN report this week warning about climate change regarding drastic action?
It was given to me. It was given to me, and I want to look at who drew it. You know, which group drew it, because I can give you reports that are fabulous and I can give you reports that aren't so good. But I will be looking at it, absolutely.
What do you think about Hope Hicks' new job thought?
I think it's fantastic. Hope?
Yeah.
She's the greatest. I love it. I think Hope is, I'm so proud of her. And I'm very happy. I'm very happy for you, right? Was that announced officially now?
It was, yeah.
I'm very happy for Fox, because they have a winner. Hope is a winner. And she has been from the beginning. She was like literally right from first day. That was a small group. And now I'm very proud of Hope. And Fox has themselves somebody who's really great.
Mr. President, on it all, the petroleum industry opposes this idea of moving to 15% ethanol year round. They say it's going to hurt their industry. What do you say to that?
Well, I want more industry. I want more energy. I want more because I don't like $74. It's up to $74. And if I have to do more, whether it's through ethanol or through another means, that's what I want. I want low prices. So I'm okay with it. You know, it's an amazing substance. You look at the Indy cars, they run 100% on ethanol. And you look at other certain forms of very modern energy, it's ethanol-based. And that meant a lot to me. But what really means is we're helping our farmers. And we're also going to be helping our refiners. And you know that, too, because they're both very important groups. But the farmers have been so terrific, and they produce great product. So I think it's going to be great. And it has no impact 12 months. That was a misnomer. It really has. There is no negative impact. In fact, there are those that say, you do this, and the air is cleaner. I agree with that. But they say, you go 12 months instead of 8. you go 12 months and the air is actually cleaner.
Mr. President!
Just yesterday, Dean filed an ethics complaint against Nikki Haley, famous student.
Who did? No, I know nothing about it. I know nothing about it. I know Nikki. This is one of the most honest human beings you'll ever see. So I haven't heard about that.
Mr. President, sir.
Senator from South Carolina, sir.
Say it.
Would you like to see Nikki Haley be the next U.S. Senator from South Carolina?
Well, that all depends on who she's going to be running against. I mean, I can tell you, you have some two really good ones right there right now. So I don't see her doing that, no. Well, Lindsey's a terrific guy. I think he wants to stay right where he is. Certainly I would. But I think he's really happy. I'll tell you what, Lindsey really stepped up over the last 2 or 3 weeks. I thought it was fantastic. So Lindsey's a popular guy, and Tim is a popular guy. I think those are two people. And Nikki doesn't have that in mind at all.
Is Senator Graham popular enough to be your next Attorney General, sir?
He is somebody that never asked me that question. I think he's very happy where he is. He's having a good time. And he really stepped it up. He's doing great. Oh, yeah, 100%. That's right. But I didn't know her. I mean, she supported somebody over me in the primary. It turned out very well for me. She respected it. And after that, we got along, as you would say, very well. She helped me in the election, you know, once I won the primaries. And we've really been friends, and we've been compatriots. We've done a great job together. You know, the United Nations is at, I think, really a new level of respect. And we work together. We had a tremendous week last week. So, no, Nikki wants to work with us. And also, to keep it going, she wants to work. I guess she said today a few times to a few of you, she wants to work on the 2020 election with us. Yeah, I think they were. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not going to say who I mean. I'm just telling you had forces saying things that were evil. They were bad people. And he is a very, very fine man. And what was said about him should never have been said. I know fellow Americans that are evil. Are you saying we shouldn't say that a fellow American is evil? I've known some fellow Americans that are pretty evil. Go ahead.
Well, I like to see low interest rates. The Fed is doing what they think is necessary, but I don't like what they're doing because we have inflation really jet and we have a lot of good things happening. So I will say this, we're normalizing money and that's good, but I think we don't have to go as fast. I want to be able to pay off debt. Also, and very importantly, I think that the numbers that we're producing are record-setting. I don't want to slow it down even a little bit, especially when you don't have the problem of inflation and you don't see that inflation coming back. Now, at some point it will and you go up. I just don't think it's necessary to go as fast. I have not spoken to him about that. No, I like to stay uninvolved with him. I have not spoken. How are you? Well, he's very talented, but no, I haven't. Only because I know you people. What would you do if I said that, right? What would they do? Jared or Ivanka? How do you feel about Ivanka? I think CNN would support her. Look, they're two very competent people. Well, I guess he's going before Congress. We had a very good talk yesterday. And he's going before Congress. We'll see how it all works out. In the meantime, as you know, Senator Richard Burr came out just recently and said there was no collusion. He saw no collusion. It was after, what, a year and a half. And Devin Nunes, as you know, very smart people. He came out, there's no collusion. There is no collusion. So that's all I care about. We'll start getting it.